스푼제이.
하이리.
스푼제이.
게이리.
스푼잼.
Alright.
Wait, hang on.
Frank.
Spoon Jam.
There we go.
That was awesome. Spoon
That's
jam.
A Spoon Jam with Katie Morgan.
All right. That's actually a first. Is that a first for you?
No, yeah, it's the name
I've
of one of your porns.
I've never Spoon Jammed before. Oh. I was in the movie, but we didn't have spoons.
Katie Morgan's hanging out with us. She's one of the stars of the expert panel of the show. That Sex Show is hosted by our own Heidi Hamilton.
Thank you.
On Monday, it premieres February 4th at 11 p.m. on the Logo Network, Logo Channel. So look it up on your cable and find that. And it says here, Katie Morgan, panelist, former porn star. She is basically whatever. Who's getting the most? I mean, obviously, you guys have done some test shows and some calls.
Technical run throughs and stuff, yeah.
Because it's a live show, so we're not going to see recorded episodes.
No.
We're going to see live.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Television, which is
Five
always
nights
fun.
A week.
Five nights a week, video chat.
Anything can happen on live TV. That's all I'm going to watch.
You're like, oh, watch your screw up. They're going to be talking.
No.
Wait,
I'm watch your screw
what,
up.
What? They're talking to my head. Where the phones are down. What's happening?
Heidi's going to be fantastic. I'm sure it's going to be a great show. But yeah, it's live television, so anything can happen. In the test shows, I mean, we had Dougal on, the psychic, and we haven't had the doctor on yet.
I think he's Dr. Mike Dow. I think he's going to come in tomorrow, and he's a sex and relationship therapist.
Who's fielding the most? I mean, with Katie Morgan, you know, in studio as an expert, I'm thinking a lot of people are like, I want to ask Katie a question. I got Katie, you know.
That's true.
But it's not even just about asking one person or another. It's about looking at it from mind, body, and spirit. We have just the whole panel. So whatever the question is, it's usually good to get it from at least two angles, if not all three.
Yeah. Which you're used to in porn.
I get it from so many angles.
You got to get it from two angles, three angles, you know. Yeah, I would say that Katie weighs in on almost everything.
Most of them,
I mean,
yeah.
we all do, but yeah, I mean, there are obviously a lot of sex and relationship questions, but yeah, Katie's got the answers to everything. She's done everything.
If it's about positions, it goes to me.
Yeah. Now, it's on the Logo Network, but this show is not specifically for any one audience.
It's for everybody.
That's the beauty.
It's for anyone who has an interest in sexuality or relationships and would like to listen to an open dialogue about it.
I love you. She is selling.
So if you've never, watched the Logo Channel, because you think you might not like any of the programming on that, they're stepping out, I guess.
This show is fantastic.
It could be on any network.
I will say, even if I wasn't on the show, hosting the show, I would watch it every night.
Me too.
It's so good and compelling, and to hear and to see some of the questions that people ask, it's stuff that you're like, whoa, I didn't even know that sort of thing existed. Or of course, Katie always knows. Oh yeah, yeah.
They've shocked all of us at least a couple times.
Yeah, that
is
true.
With some of the run throughs. Yeah, I mean, there's been moments, the Alka-Seltzer moment, everyone's jaw hit the floor.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Can imagine.
Who knew? I got shocked last night. We were doing some technical run-throughs, and Katie decided to show the laundromat video. We should probably, I don't even know if we can put that on our website, but she goes to, it was an undercover camera show or something?
Yeah,
what was that?
A hidden camera scene from Katie Takes Manhattan on HBO, and I did, the goal was to get other people to give me their clothes at the laundromat, so I did that by taking mine off, and it worked
well. You were like, spilled something. You were like, oh,
I spilled laundry soap all over me.
She's in disguise, so she's got like dark hair and glasses, and then she's like, oh, I spilled something. Imagine, you're at the laundromat.
People take the shirts off their backs. And
they did, literally.
Just the sweetest guys, like going, like, you see them looking, but not wanting to look, and trying to be polite, and he's like, I can give you, I mean, I don't, she's just standing there, big giant boobies, and she's like, oh, I gotta throw this in the washer, I don't have anything else. And they did. Every single person gave you clothes, which kind of shocks me. Like, you'd think, no, I'm not giving her clothes. I want
to
look at her. I don't want to cover her up with my big bag of
t-shirts. But I asked so nicely. I did. I was very polite.
Yeah, polite. Then you want to be, the knight in shining armor, the chivalrous guy.
Hey, there is one chick.
One chick took off her top?
Well, I mean, no, but yes.
She was there doing laundry, she pulls something out and goes, you could put this on. You should probably cover up. And then she starts talking about, oh, are the boobs new? Oh, they look new. It's fantastic.
You have successfully crossed over with your acting and everything like that with your HBO shows. Your name, I guess, when people want to, they're like, oh, yeah, Katie Morgan. Everyone kind of knows who you are now.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the porn industry getting closer to where there's not the porn industry and everything else. It's like that there is that kind of a mesh now. Do you think we're close to that, or it's getting closer?
I think it's definitely getting closer. It's so much closer than it used to be, obviously, because it started happening with me and some other girls that have actually been able to make the transition. There was a time where if you do a porn, you will just never, ever do anything else.
And it's almost blacklisting yourself.
Yes, it was. There was a time when it was literally blacklisting yourself, and it's not anymore. But I don't know how close we are to the full integration. I mean, we'll see. It's definitely happening
full
more and
integration.
More.
Full integration.
Yeah.
Hey, it all started together. They were shooting porn right when they started shooting movies. First thing is on camera. So,
right.
And then it went
the
apart.
The silent pornos.
And now back together. Hey, some of those are really dirty.
I know.
Shocking.
Crazy dirty.
I need sound.
Because I'm bringing this up because there was a commercial that CBS said it's refusing to air during the Super Bowl, and it just shows two old people sitting on a park bench. They're looking out at the park, and it's a very sweet moment. The old lady reaches up and touches the old man's shoulder and gives him the knowing look, like, oh, I love you. Look at this beautiful place. And then the camera, you know, facing them, backs away a little bit, and then Pornhub comes up. So it's not dirty at all.
No,
but
it just has the word.
When Pornhub comes up and says, you know what? We're not going to allow that to run during the Super Bowl because I guess we're not there yet.
No, the word porn scares people. It still does. Absolutely. I mean, look at Zach and Mary Make a Porno. They couldn't get the first poster up because it had pictures of people and the word porno, and they ended up just with the drawings so that they could still have the word in the movie. And even then, a lot of marquees only put Zach and Mary because they didn't want it.
Yeah. I didn't even know that was. So do you think, have you ever had a problem saying it when somebody says, so what do you do? Like, meeting new people and they're like, what do you do?
Well, I mean, if I'm not trying to be shocking and they don't know me, I'll just say, I'm an actress.
Oh, is there anything that we've seen you in?
Oh, maybe. Do you watch HBO?
It was called Blacklist Yourself.
Oh. I don't know. I'm trying to think. That would be tough, I think, if somebody's asking you what you do and then...
I guess I don't generally strike up random conversations anymore with strangers. Like, people will come up and talk to me, but I'm not like, hey, how are you doing in the elevator? I'm an actress. What do you do? Like, I just don't strike up those conversations.
A couple of days ago, I was in Macy's. I had to buy something, and I had one of those chatty sales girls. And so I'm checking out. She goes, you're blonde. You're such pretty blonde hair, blah, blah, blah. Oh, thank you so much. She goes, so what do you do for a living? And I told her, and I promoted the show, by the way,
nice.
You know, our shows and all that. But I'm thinking, if you're in a situation like that, you're a Macy's, and she's like, oh, you're so pretty. I like your shirt. Oh, so what do you do?
Oh, I just say I'm an actress.
Just say you're an actress.
Yeah.
You don't go into the porn thing.
I don't go. No, unless they're giving me the winky, looky face, like, so what do you do? Like,
so you
I
can,
know what you do.
So you can tell. You can tell, like, if you're out somewhere and a guy is looking at you, you know that he knows you. He's not just looking at a hot chick.
It takes a minute. There's a look of recognition that definitely comes over people's faces where they're like looking at you like, do I know you from high school? And then they're like, oh, and they get that look in their eye. Yeah. And you're like, oh, hi.
So with this commercial, the Pornhub commercial, which is kind of brilliant because they got all the press they're getting that they would have got for paying $4 million for having it actually play during the Super Bowl.
Right.
Agree with CBS and all right, they shouldn't do that.
Look at the fallout from Nipplegate. I mean, that was Super Bowl. So yeah, I see them doing the whole family thing. I mean, it's regular network television. I think that's going to take longer than anything else. But look what's on Comedy Central. Look what we're doing on Logo. We're definitely getting there. But CBS, NBC, ABC. I don't know.
The Super Bowl.
Give them a minute.
Yeah.
Give them another decade.
Yeah, our show wouldn't be on NBC.
Right.
Or CBS.
You probably couldn't do an ad for our show for the Super Bowl.
Right. No.
Our show barely could be on the radio. I mean, seriously.
They say it daily. That show is barely on the radio.
when we come back, we're going to have the news featuring Katie Morgan. When we come back, the Mystery News Theater, find out what Katie's going to do when we return.
Oh, my.
We are Heidi and Frank.
Oh, that was just a little sample of the Heidi and Frank Show on 95.5 KLOS. To get more samples like this and hear all the fun we have, you can do that at 955KLOS.com. Now, to get the show in its entirety, on demand, and if you want to watch the show, we webcast it every day, all you have to do is go to HeidiandFrank.com and become a premium package member. Do it right now.